world of the living, there are those who quest to know the truth. In the realm of death, there is energy that lingers long into the afterlife. Our mission, to make the connections and answer the questions that exist on both sides of reality. We are Ghost Finders.
Nice to meet you.
It's nice
Rob
to meet
Thompson.
You.
Thank you, Rob. So much for having us here to do this investigation. Really looking forward to investigating this really majestic and extraordinary landmark of Honesdale. Can you tell us a bit about the building?
Sure. Yes, the original purpose of the building was a boarding house for the supervisors that were working on the canals in the area that brought the coal to the East Coast in New York City. Bringing a lot of workers in here, they needed housing for that, and then subsequent travelers and the business people that follow that sort of industry.
They would all gather here.
The coal in this area was actually the birthplace of the Industrial Revolution from the East Coast.
Yep.
This was significant.
Yep.
So actually, this structure was a significant part of that.
A main hub, if you will, and like the coal tycoons, and they would
correct, yes,
stay
yep.
here on business.
Business, yeah. There was a construction, then there was the commerce that followed, and ongoing maintenance, everything. Every purpose that there.
Yeah. Now there've been a lot of reports varying greatly from staff member to a guest. You've been manager here for how long?
About 3 years now.
Okay. What are your personal experiences here in the building?
You hear scattered stories and you discount them. It's an old building. Things happen, things move and shift, and you're not in every place at any given time.
Right.
When you start thinking about it, the different doors left open, sounds made, guests reporting things, staff reporting.
Any one particular incident that springs to mind, maybe?
Just recently we had an incident in one of our restrooms. We walked in the middle of the day and it was covered in steam. Inexplicably, no reason that we could determine that would happen.
Really?
And
steam.
We looked at each other, we had our engineer look at it, and there's no cause that we could think of. Never happened before or since, just in that one room, that one time, and we can't figure it out to save our life. All the fixtures were hot to the touch. There's nothing that, anywhere near that would have caused that. So,
can you show us a bit around that
floor? Sure, absolutely.
This is a fabulous staircase. I mean, it really is. It's something that had gone with the wind. you can almost feel, how... with the history, how many people have come up and down this staircase?
Sure, when we have weddings, the wedding parties, all the pictures are taken here.
Who's this gentleman?
This is Philip Hone. He's the founder of Honesdale, after Homer's name.
Honesdale, that's...
He was mayor of New York City at one point, and then became significant in the canals. He's a local artist, Howard Becker. We had 23 of his paintings throughout the building, but he was a fixture in the downtown. You'd see him painting out in the square, and
it's a fabulous collection of paintings. Is this pretty much as it was also during the time? These rooms were...
The layout was the same. You could see the transoms were glass, at one point.
Yeah.
It had been different uses. People had stayed here long-term. Sometimes it was a hotel, sometimes it was like an apartment or boarding house.
Anyone see anything on this level? Hear anything?
Well, we do. I mean, the door is opening. On the left-hand side here, we've heard doors rattling. That was a story at one point from one of our guests. And again, we attribute it to many things, but...
The doors would just...
The doors left open, when they thought they were locked, that sort of...
Yeah, that's probably hard to do because these are good,
right,
solid doors.
They don't do it easily. And a room seemed to be disturbed that they were certain were not occupied or they were cleaned. You know, we go through this with the housekeeping staff. You know, I know I cleaned that room.
Right.
And then the covers pulled up or something of that nature.
What about the next floor? Okay. Now, this is the third floor?
Correct.
All right. Yeah, this corridor feels really...
I take a wild guess here that this is where a lot of the reports have happened.
Mostly, yeah. If I had to characterize it, it is mostly on this floor. You know, it's the most removed from the populated areas. You know, it's quieter up here, and
you can almost feel it. You can't quite put your finger on it, but you can almost feel some kind of energy going on here. This would be one of the first places that we'll be investigating, Jim. Thank you so much for having us here, and we really appreciate it. Looking forward to starting this investigation, and we'll let you know what we find. Give you a call in the morning and let you know.
We'll be anxious to hear.
Yeah.
You know, and thank you for coming. This is exciting.
Always a pleasure.
The whole staff wants to know.
Okay, so this is the basement. All right. So what sort of things do you experience when you're coming down here and stop?
Yeah. I normally come down here all by myself where there's nobody in the place.
Okay.
To stock my beer and things like that. So
okay.
I have to come over here. And as I'm walking over here, I have to unlock the beer cooler, things like that. I go in and out of the beer cooler quite often. And there's always like shadows out of the corner of my eyes, like I always see stuff over in that hallway area.
Of your peripheral vision, then, or?
Usually. That piece of glass hasn't always been there, obviously, but I have tried to decipher like whether or not it was my own shadow. It never seems to be me.
Okay.
I also come down here quite often and always feel like somebody's watching me. You come around the corner here, like these boxes are usually like always stacked, and this is how it looks on a majority of time when we come down here, and we're always like yelling at each other who knocked the boxes, but that's just us. And over here is always freezing. I always get chills when I come over here. I hate it over here.
Just like
somebody's watching me, though.
Hair on the back of your head, yes. Going, oh, okay, yeah, that's
usually easier. When I come down this corner, the hair on my arm and back of my neck always thin.
That's a good indicator, yeah, that you got company. Let's go and take a look rest of the place and get set up and start this investigation. Golden hour is approaching. It's just before 12:30, and we are about to go dark, being about 4.5 hours setting up. We have numerous cameras in some interesting locations where there have been reports of activity. Here on the ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor, basement area, the main staircase area here, and also the view going up the staircase, just in case we see any full-bodied or partial-bodied apparitions peeking over one of the floors, or one of the flights of stairs. We're splitting two teams up, and Heather is going to be spending an hour solitary in darkness, alone in room 321, while we begin our investigation. Amy and I are going to take Heather to room 321 and get her all checked in. Jakey, you got the K2?
Got the
K2. Switched on? Okay, let's go do this. Go dark. Switch to night vision. Ghost finders?
Yes, sir.
Let's go. Here, we'll make you comfortable in room 321. Oh, hello, we're back, just returning, and Heather's going to join you to talk. Okay, dude? Thank you so much. May she come in?
Don't talk away, I'll turn off.
Have fun, darling. Thank you both, and we'll talk to you later.
Okay, so right now, before I turn the lights off, I'm just gonna get situated. I guess I'll sit right here.
We're on the third floor, and we're kicking it off. Let's go ahead, have a look and see. Okay, we're going now to one of the other rooms where there was reports of activity.
Okay, just...
Did you hear that?
Okay, just...
Did you hear that?
Yes, it's still rolling. But, come talk to me. Bet you miss your friend. I hope it's a good friend you had that looked like me. Do you miss them? I hope it's a good friend you had that looked like me. I hope it's a good friend you had that looked like me. Do you miss them? Were you young when you passed away? You're in your 20s? Yeah? You're in your 20s? Yeah. Were you staying here overnight? Or did you live here? Yeah? Did you overdose by accident? Yeah? Was it just a hard time in your life? So did you say you've seen the light? Question. Yeah. Yeah, you did? So there is a light. I actually just felt the K2 move in my hand a little bit. I can see you're really going for it. Yeah. Amazing. Rob, this is Heather.
Hey, Glenn.
I think I'm done up here. Like I said, I want to say thank you for speaking with us. Are you holding the door? Really? We're holding the door?
No.
This is great.
talk about corroborating evidence.
Yeah.
Guys?
You guys get an angle?
It's Justin and Rob in the hallway of the second floor. There we go. You too?
Yeah.
Okay. If you understand what we're saying, then I want you to make that light up on a count of three. One, two, three. That's great.
That's great.
Beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. That means you know we can use this now to communicate. Okay. If there is more than one of you here right now, then can you make it light up?
Very good.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. All right, wonderful. Oh, wow.
Wow.
Orange. Okay, there is a lot of you. Okay. Okay, back away from the device, and let's ask you another question now that we know that there are many of you. Or several of you. Yes, yes, there are. I understand. Oh my gosh, I am freezing. Okay, step away from these two hands holding boxes right now. Step away from them. If you don't move away, I won't ask any more questions, and you'll miss your opportunity to communicate.
Thank you.
All right. Now, all of you, we thank you for so far everything you're doing to communicate. Thank you. Yes. Thank you. All right. Now move back away because Justin here is going to ask you. Where's this guy? He's going to ask you some questions. So back away again, or there won't be any more questions.
Please back away. Thank you.
Okay, take it away, Jackie.
Are there more than five of you here? Were you all tenants here at one point? That's great. Were you perhaps very wealthy? Ooh, I'm spiking hard.
I guess that's a yes. Oh, well, me too. Yes, it is a yes.
So, was your death related to money?
Yes. It was. Were you feel you were just used for your money? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm freezing cold. Me too. My arm just went hard. Every hair on my hand. Okay, that's not nice to be used for your money. It must be strange for you to suddenly be with people who not only know that you're here, but allow you to have some kind of a two-way conversation. Is it an odd experience for you right now? Okay, yeah. It's pretty odd and interesting for us, but it's what we do. Are you enjoying this conversation with us
Okay. Okay. All right. Well, we are too. We would very much like to be your friend. Would you like to be our friend? Okay. Thank you. And we care about your feelings and your considerations and those of your... Yeah. I believe you said thank you. Are you done talking with us? No? Let's make it light up one more time. Okay. Would you like us to leave? Okay. Okay, we're gone.
We'll leave. Thank you very much.
And so ends our investigation of this historic hotel, Hotel Wayne, here in Honesdale, Pennsylvania, on this episode of Ghost Finders.
Hello.
So.
Peek-a-boo.
Let's go downstairs to the basement. The terrifying. Without further ado, it's time for us to explore the terrifying basement. The basement area of the Hotel Wayne. The Wayne area of the hotel basement.